we are now having nearly 700,000 vehicles in Wuhan, which is really very big. The number is increasing, still increasing very, very fast. And this makes raise some quite a lot of problems. One of the traffic jam, of course, is very obvious. Pollution to the environment, and also the the parking problems.
More and more people become rich in China now. They also could have the capabilities to own the cars. The problem is in the city or from the national government also, they don't have the real policies to control the car use. So the cars will become more and more, and within this densely developed area. So now the only way is they want to have a more road, wider road. I noticed that for the new master planning, now they have different kind of ring road. And it seems like for the within this ring road to the 2020, it seems the color becomes the brown and becomes the red and no green anymore. Also, you know, in the 1980s, there are a lot of bicycles to be used in Wuhan, but now it becomes less and less because people think this is a risk to ride a bicycle in the street. Why? Because a lot of the cars to be used in the street. But I don't think this is a real real solutions to solve the problems of the transportation problem in Wuhan. So I hope in the future they still can put the bicycles use in the important place.
2005年，南京市开始拟定这个交通白皮书，发展白皮书。那么这白皮书的这个制定，可以说可以为将来我们南京市交通的发展制定了系统的发展政策、发展规划和具体对外交通和城市内部交通的协进换乘体系还没有成立。而且呢，由于跨越我们的秦淮河，所以通道资源呢是很紧张的。那么针对这个问题，首先是从土地使用上面，应该严格按照总体规划规定的这个来进行进一步的落实，像提高像河西的商业、这个用地、办公用地、这个等相关用地的，就是。能够实现河西新城中间的这个居住和就业的这个平衡问题，那同时呢，要增加我们新城跟河西新城和新市区和我们主城区的联系通道。那么现在跨越的仅仅有汉中门、清凉门、这个草场门啊、定环门，那么这几个有限的通道是不够的，我们应该采用多模式、多通道方式来加强和主城的这个交通联系，尤其是要加强地铁六号线的这个建设的速度，使得主城、新城中间的大部分居民能够利用新的交通方式来实现这个新城跟主城的这种联系。同时呢，要增加一些这个人行通道、自行车通道，那么实现这个通道的多通道、多模式的这个交通利用。